I'd hoped you wouldn't have to witness this.
Where's Ciri?
Nearby. Listen.
Shut up. I've heard enough of your bullshit. Draw your weapon. Let's get this over with.
I think you will not attack one unarmed.
Wouldn't be so sure. I'm in a foul mood.
I am not your foe. I am merely helping Cirilla.
I don't believe you. Can't. Not after all that's happened.
Will you believe me? Avalok speaks the truth. I asked him to help me open the tower, because I aim to enter it.
Worthwhile to tell me? Warn me of your plans?
I'm sorry, I know I should have. But I feared you'd not understand.
Feels like I'm talking to Yennefer. Leave with me, please.
I will, Geralt. Once I emerge from the tower. If I emerge.
Why the hell would you do this? The Wild Hunt's been defeated.
The White Frost has not. The prophecies are true. I have seen worlds bound in ice. I know what awaits you. Only the Elderblood can stop the White Frost. Only I can stop it.
Prophecy is drivel. Destruction is not our fate.
You have seen the future, don't you remember? Entropy cannot be stopped. The worlds will freeze one after the other, and all life will perish.
Avalok is right. If I do nothing, humans, elves, all will face destruction.
There's gotta be another way.
What can you know about saving the world, silly? You're but a witcher. This is my story, not yours. You must let me finish telling it.
Good luck, Ciri.
Perhaps I should have told you. I see now you might have understood.
Know you better than you think. Keep me waiting.
Thank you. to me a day.
The gentleman will follow.
Captain!
Report, 4th Kite Squadron. The Fundsberg Division as a whole. Deserters.
Does General Voorhis know?
He's at a briefing. They're not letting anyone in.
Nonsense. Getting there.
War in Eidfein.
His
Imperial
here
Majesty,
decision must be taken now.
Speak. Ciri is dead.
How did it happen?
The White Cold. You're familiar with the prophecy? Ciri tried to stop it. She did, but paid the ultimate price.
Where is the body?
I doubt it'll ever be found.
Who else knows?
Avalach, Elven Sage. But I doubt you'll find him either.
And Yennefer?
She's decided to stay in the north. Provided you don't object.
I don't. And you?
Someone's waiting for me.
Triss Marigold. Fear not. I do not intend to have her pursued. Did Cirilla say... Did she ask you to convey anything?
We didn't talk about you.
I see.
If there's nothing else...
There is, but you may go. Witcher! I do not wish to see you ever again.
Need a hand with your wagon?
No. It's not exactly ours. More a captured vehicle. Booty, you might say.
Folk must have abandoned it in their rush. To where, I don't know. Be a shame for the Reds to claim it, loot it.
Change is coming.
grown accustomed, we have.
With the Black Ones gone, witch hunters will move in. Yet life will roll on. We've to seize the day.
True that. So, let's get to work before night creeps up on us.
Sure you don't need any help?
I believe we will manage.
Where are you headed? Nearest inn, by the looks of it.
Yeah. Supposed to meet someone first, at the former campsite of the Nilfgaardians. You take care now.
Master Ort.
Probably got held back. You're late.
Soldiers.
Blocking the roads, I know. No matter. You have it?
As agreed. 38.5-inch blade. Weight, just under 40 ounces. Silver-plated siderite steel core. Glyphs and runes both the length of the blade and on the hilt.
Beautiful.
Been in this trade for 3 decades. Only the best swordsman of the coin for my wares. When I say no witcher has, whatever had a better weapon, you ought to trust me.
Reputation precedes you, Master Ort. I'd never doubt you.
The inscription, as you asked.
Tyrael. Swallow.
Classic Elder Speech runes. No styling. Simple and precise.
May I?
It is yours. If you'd like to test it, have my lackeys put out a training dummy.
Mm-hmm. Your payment. Gems only, as requested.
If you've an eye out for work, heard a Striggers prowling the Maribor Forest.
Thanks. Need to visit the tavern first, but after, who knows?
Good luck in the path, Witcher.
Come on.
Footprints. A dwarf's.
All right, out. How was your trip? Smooth sailing?
He's still on about that leaky tub from the Isle of Mist. You're lucky you and that lass weren't in it with us.
You'd not have fit anyhow. It was so laden, that boat. We barely made land.
And it reeked of fish manure.
You stole my boat.
Borrowed. We knew it was yours. Still is. You don't think we'd do that to a mate like you? Plough you soapless while you slept off a bender.
Oh, that's good.
So, gonna give me my boat back?
Why in the gods' names would you need a boat in this brush?
Fair enough. Forget I said anything. How'd you wind up here?
Our affairs brought us here. Hard times, you know. Got to earn a coin where you can.
Folk around here need surveyors?
We've shifted our efforts. Investors now.
Investors?
They've come for us. Hide!
Eh?
What's going on?
You've not seen us?
The dwarves, where are they?
Dwarves?
Don't feign ignorance. We've been after them since yesterday, after they stole the Reverend Nekellis' golden chalice. Anyone aiding criminals will be subject to punishment by the Holy Tribunal of the Eternal Fire.
Who's this Reverend Nekellis?
A traveling preacher. A saintly man anointed by the Hierarch himself. He's purged thousands of souls already.
By, purging, you mean the cleansing fire of the stake?
You'll know of another way.
A threat.
Don't like your tone, mutant. Will you force me to teach you respect for those who serve the eternal fire?
Give it a shot.
I want him alive! Alive! Damn it! Die! Die, Orson!
Damn, you're ugly. Of power should draw from it. Thank you.
honor in the fatherland.
Hold up, sir! I beg ye!
What's the problem?
Soldiers bound him. There! In the hut!
Bound who?
They've got me dad, and Uncle Bogart, and Klimko. Help me!
Sod off! In the name of the king!
I don't even know how to move.
We shall see.
I swear by all the gods that...
Ha! Blasphemy! Been some time since we've had...
Best give up for now! Yeah. Try to get round him! He's a quick devil! No!
Spreads disease, defeatism, and desertion.
He was right away to be near the guardians, the spies. He's hidden all week now.
Witches, false healers, charm merchants, and filthy non-humans are hereby deemed outlaws. All who provide shelter to or otherwise affect their life shall be tried and executed by the will of the Holy Tribunal of the Eternal.
Is it done?
Yes.
Did he believe you?
I have no idea.
For the cockatrice. And we've a new contract. It won't pay much, but I think it worth the toil.
You've been busy. It's yours.
A witch's sword. Swallow. Ooh, beautiful. May I?
Not here. You'll have ample opportunity soon enough, Witcher.
Let's try it out then.
Radovid had many faults. He was cruel, impetuous, and pathologically ambitious. But he was a tactical genius. That's undeniable. Commanding forces far outnumbered by his foes, he handily defeated the invader from the south. The Redanian Eagle spread its wings, taking all the north, including Novigrad, beneath them. With victory in the war against Nilfgaard secured, Radovid proceeded to complete his witch hunt. As they had in Novigrad, pyres burned in Temeria and Edirne, lands now liberated by the Redanian monarch. In the drive for moral renewal, simple herbalists, pellers, healers, and non-humans, all supposed heretics, were murdered in droves. For many, freedom beneath Radovid's scepter proved more tragic than servitude to another. As long as his armies went from one victory to the next, Emir's subjects remained boundlessly obedient. When a string of humiliating defeats proved Var Emry's fallible, the opposition, thus far secret, attacked. The subjects of the Emperor who had danced on the graves of his foes laid him to rest in a tomb of his own. While the continent bled engulfed by war, Skellige bloomed under Ceres' enlightened rule. Unlike those who had come before her, the young queen did not raid foreign shores, looking instead to her people, tending to her land. The island-bound nation prospered, though its fangs of yore were dulled. Cyrilla Fiona Ellen Rhiannon, heir to Nilfgaard's throne, chose the life of a witcher on the path. Geralt taught her all he knew, every skill he possessed, then each set off on their own. Soon, word of the ashen-haired witcheress had spread throughout the north, from the Yoruga to the mountains of Kovir. Hard as it may be to believe, Geralt planted roots in faraway Kovir. He and Triss settled down, their home warm and smelling of freshly baked cakes. Guests were always welcome, no matter the day or the hour. The witcher would take jobs at times more from habit than need, for Triss earned a true fortune as the mage advisor to Kovir's king.
Thank you.